Now, in the pictures we've seen from inside Westfield, you can see the hero police officer running towards that knife-wielding man moments before she takes him down. And in the picture, two men are seen running along with her to help.
I'm going to go live now to one of those men, Ryan Bramble, and his friends Giorgio Di Lorenzo and Nick Torek, who are also there. All three men joins us now. Gentlemen, thank you. Ryan, let's start with you. We saw the vision of you there running behind. Just tell us exactly what happened.
I was just shopping with my two mates in Zara downstairs. We heard screaming and just all these women and children running, and we thought, like, they were running out the door, so we went towards the commotion. As we went towards the commotion, the bloke walked around the corner and, yeah, he was just walking casually with a knife. He looked at me and, like, he was only a few metres away from me and sort of just hesitated a little bit and kept going. And then a second after that, the police ran in off the street. And she said to me, she's like, where's the bloke? And I pointed in the direction to the bloke. And we all started chasing after the guy, and we chased him up the escalators and for 300 metres. And then we got to the end. She told him to drop it. She gave him a couple of chances. And he stopped, and he stopped, turned around at us, and she drew a gun. And she told him to... She let it go three times into his chest.
Just
because you talked over each other and the line's a bit difficult, just one of you say, what did she say and what was the reaction?
She just said, she said drop it, and she hadn't even had a gun drawn at that time. It was still in a holster, and she asked him to drop it. And he still didn't. He paused and he had the knife like this, and then he went to just charge at us. And as he's charged at us, she drew the gun and just blew him away. Three shots, bang, straight in his chest.
And, Giorgio, what did you think of her? I mean, she's being called the hero cop. Do you think she was pretty brave the way she bolted in there and how she kept her cool?
Absolutely amazing, honestly, to do that. And then I was part of the standoff when he turned around and looked at us all and looked at her. And he sort of gauged his options and then just ran at her. And for her to act that quickly was amazing.
Yeah, and Nick, what about you? Because we've been trying to get a piece of the character or piece together this person's character. Were any words said? Demeanour? Help us fill in that picture.
Well, yeah, I just feel he was completely unhinged. He was just lost the plot. Because when I was in Zara just buying clothes, and there was a point where he comes to the front of the shop, and he just, like, looks at everyone in Zara and kind of threatens them but doesn't go in. And then there was, like, a moment where he was just scratching his head with the knife, like, just, and nobody was home. Yeah. And then from that point, he ran up the escalators, and then that's when the other cop came. And then before you know it, there's a group of us just chasing him, and it goes all the way around the corner.
His eyes were black. They were jet black. Like, he wasn't there in the head.
He was, I don't know. And he was really skinny and just, like, he didn't look healthy, and he was, yeah.
And he didn't say anything at any stage when you were...
No. Not the whole time.
No, he didn't say anything. Yeah.
Did it look to you like he was deliberately trying to target women, or was that just the people who were easy?
Random. I think it was really random. It looked like to me he was just trying to target people that were weaker than him.
Yeah, because
women, children, old people, anybody that was weaker than him. Because he looked at us, he looked at me, and he had a second thought and kept going.
He didn't.
Any guy that was there, he could see in the other footage, the guy with the cap on, he went up to him and he.
Yeah.
Anybody that was a bit of a threat to him, he just didn't go with it. He just went to someone else
on the way. And that's what it seemed like.
Yeah.
Giorgio, the detective inspector, we were told, and if you could clarify this, it would help some of the reporting, that in the seconds after this person was shot, a number of shots fired, that the detective inspector then at the very least, knelt down and tried to, I don't know, it was reported that CPR was attempted, but could you tell us accurately what happened?
Most definitely, CPR was attempted, but there was just sort of blood coming out of everywhere. Like, it didn't actually... There was no point in doing it whatsoever.
Yeah. He was dead before he hit the ground.
It was completely pointless. It was not good to watch, to be honest.
Yeah.
And what was the composure of the police officer after she shot him? She was calm?
She was shaking. She had adrenaline pumping. She was shaking. I said to her, congratulations, well done. And she was shaking. She could barely talk. she was awesome, but like,
yeah,
but the professionalism just, from her was, yeah, was unreal. Just, she just came in off the street by herself,
yeah,
just took charge, said, where is he? And just went for him.
Yeah.
No hesitation at all.
What happens then, gentlemen, because obviously there are other people around at the same time, so many people have witnessed, you've witnessed it directly, and I'm feeling for you in that sense, but did people feel reassured? Were they in shock? Did other people start running? What happened?
It was a bit difficult because people didn't know what was going on. We were there, so we knew the subject was gone. He was dead, so there was no more threat. But the rest of the centre, the alarm was going off. Everybody thought there was a wild gunman running around shooting other people. There was multiple people. It was a terrorist attack.
Two or one person.
You know, we actually got outside and we didn't know he'd kill people. I thought it was just a loony running around with a knife.
Yeah. Oh, goodness me. So you weren't aware of that?
We didn't know anybody had died. And we got outside and there was 20 ambulances there. And we looked, why are all these ambulances? What's going on? Because he'd killed all those people first. And that's when we were in Zara. And he walked around the corner and he was by himself. Everybody had bailed and scattered from him. He walked around the corner and he was just walking with a knife. And, yeah, so after he'd killed everybody, that's when we saw him.
Well, James, to that point then, and this is crucial, given the state that you saw him in, do you believe he would have then gone on to continue attacking?
Oh, 100%. He was looking for his next victim.
He was just walking around looking.
But looking for his next person.
But what's odd is he had plenty of opportunity to attack multiple people.
He was only a few metres away from us, but he didn't
do it. Which is luxury. I don't understand the mentality behind it. But, so no idea the motive, just from the sounds of it, completely unhinged.
So just to explain, so from what you're saying, when you gave chase, you didn't realise that he had hurt anyone. So were you just running to sort of help the police officer? But then once you realised that he'd been on this, you know, awful trail of violence, I mean, what were you thinking then?
You could have put your life on the line. I chased him with the cop, with the police officer, because she was by herself, just to back her, purely to back her up. And, the guy had a knife.
At the end of the day, the guy had a knife and there was a group of us. And if we really wanted
men,
to...
He was by himself with a knife. You know,
it's not like he had a gun at the end of the day. There's enough chairs and stuff, I'm sure. If he attacked the police officer and, God forbid, something happened to
him. I don't know why somebody didn't stop him before this when, you know, I don't know. I wasn't there when he killed the other people. But I'm quite upset that it wasn't stopped before this.
Yeah.
Well, it looks like some people tried, because we saw the bloke with the bollard on the escalator, which must have happened in the sequence of events, before.
There's a lot of strong men in there.
I'm in Zara and there's a bunch of big boys everywhere, and everyone just scatters like mouse. And I'm like, what's going on here? If the bloke's got a knife, not a gun.
It wasn't a gun.
Something had to happen, and that was just the instinct to just help the police officer and chase up.
To be perfectly honest with you, to answer your question, after we thought he died, and we thought the threat was good, we were all happy. We didn't know he killed people before that. So when we got outside and we discovered that, and all the ambulances kept coming, we kind of went down a little bit.
We were very lucky.
How lucky we were that...
I basically didn't confront him, but was literally a few metres away from him, and he walked straight... I was very, very lucky guy.
Can I just clarify, the pictures that we're looking at, was it one of you men who had the chair, or was that another?
That's me in the footage. I'm running with another guy. So as we were running with the police officer, he picked up the chair as we were running along from a cafe or something.
Yeah.
Hey, Nick, just take us back to that moment that you described from inside the Zara store, because I find that quite haunting. You said he scratched his head with the blade at one point and stared through the window?
So pretty much I was in the Zara store, and then everyone just starts running into the Zara store, and he was right at the front just before you got to the escalators, like at the shop front, and it was just a moment where he was just like scratching his head with the knife and just like looking down, just like it was like, what have I done kind of situation, and he just was confused, and then from that moment, I don't know, something else snapped in his head, and then he started storming up the escalators, and then from that point, the police officer started chasing, and then it went from the first floor to the second floor, and then that's where it ended.
And Ryan, at the end there, where it ended, you described a little bit about the state of the detective inspector. She's done an incredible thing. She's prevented him from going on to attack more people. But obviously shaken, a lot of adrenaline going through her system. Did other officers then arrive to help her, to assist her in that moment then?
Yeah, that's right. She shot the bloke, killed him, down, put him in the recovery position, and then the knife was under his chest because he fell on top of the knife and sort of on his arms. She flicked the knife out towards me. The knife flicked out to the side and she put him in the recovery position, and that's when the other two officers ran around the corner and then sort of took over from her, and she stood up and I said to her, I'm going to, like, well done, you know, thank you for saving her life.
And she was
just shaking, just full on, like adrenaline pump and hectic.
Yeah, well, good on you as well for racing in behind her, and all of you for taking a bit of action at the moment that you saw you could, even though you weren't aware at the time that people had died before you. We very much appreciate you talking to you, because it's filled in some important parts of this story as well and made it a lot more accurate as well. We thank you for having a chat to us today, and gentlemen, good on you for what you did there.
You are heroes, very brave, running towards it. Thank you so much having her back.
Yeah, well said there, Angela, too, for having her back as well, which is part of the motive of why they raced in to help as well. Just extraordinary. Of all the things that we've heard over the past 24 hours, those three gentlemen's first-hand account of it all gives a real picture of what this attacker was doing, his state of mind, the fact that there were no words. Nothing was being spoken at all, and this stare, they said his eyes were black.
Yeah, and just sort of dead and soulless, you can imagine. And I also thought, just takes you back. We talk about heroes, we talk about this hero cop and how amazing what she did and how brave she was. But when you hear how he described her afterwards, like, obviously she shot him, he was dead, she was trying to perform CPR on this person who just committed carnage and yet was just shaking and couldn't
all
even
that
speak.
Adrenaline.
Like, so much emotion. You can't overstate how difficult and emotional that is for her.
And flicking the knife away just
job.
In case.
Yeah.
You know, even though, as the men said there, he was clearly dead when he hit the ground. But extraordinary. Just extraordinary. We thank them for talking to us as well.